चैप्टर नंबर 13, ओके, चैप्टर नंबर 13 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज मैग्नेट. एज यू ऑल आर फैमिलियर विद दिस वर्ड मैग्नेट्स, सो यू नो दैट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय मैग्नेट्स. सो एनीथिंग व्हिच इज अट्रैक्टेड टू अ मेटल इज नोन एज अ मैग्नेट्स. एज फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन लोकल लैंग्वेज वी कॉल इट अ चुंबक, ओके, एंड इट कैन बी फाउंड इन द मार्केट ऑल्सो. बट प्रीवियसली वी यूज टू टेक इट आउट फ्रॉम द स्पीकर्स, ओके, और यू कैन से मोस्टली द लाउड स्पीकर्स, द ओल्ड वन और द डैमेज लाउड स्पीकर्स, ओके. सो वी विल टॉक इन दिस चैप्टर, वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट मैग्नेट्स एंड इट्स properties, that means magnets and magnetisms, okay. So first of all, let's talk about what do we mean by magnet. So magnet is actually a naturally discovered things. As for example, in our universe there are many elements or there are many things, even plants and animals also, that has not been discovered. Means it is there, but it has not been found. That means that is to be discovered by some personal, okay, that means some individual who are working on it. So the discovery of a magnet, okay, the discovery of a magnet, as we know, that means it can be true or it can be false also. We don't know about that. So as it was said, or as it is said, that there was a shepherd, okay, there was a shepherd who used to take his cattle somewhere in the hills, okay, to feed the grasses. So at that time what happens, he took a rest in a piece of rocks, and to gather the cattle in one places, he used to have a stick, okay, a long stick, okay, and that stick, at the end of the stick, at the bottom of the stick, iron object was fitted. So as soon as he take a rest in that stone, and when he tries to wake up, the metal was attached to the stone. So he frightened, or dar gaya tha, okay, darne ke baad what happened, he thought what is happening. So it's not that he simply discovered that it is a magnet, no, okay, first may it he might have been frightened, or he might have been scared for that, okay. So slowly this things was spread, okay, that means something is stuck to the stones has been stuck in the piece of metals, okay, metals that are made up of iron, okay. So then from that only we came to know that it was a magnet. That means in the stone, the word lodestone, okay, the word lodestone, in a particular stone there is another kind of stone called lodestone, and it has a magnetic properties, okay. So we have two theories here about the terminology or the nomenclature of the magnets. First, the name of the shepherd, means name of that shepherd was Magnes, okay, and from that word the term magnet has been discovered. Another, the place, sorry, Magnesia was the name of the place. Place name was Magnesia, Magnesia, one thing. So in the name of that place, the word magnet has been derived. Okay, or we can say that the name of the boy, Magnus, M-A-G-N-E-S, name of boy, of shepherd, Magnus. So from these two words, we get the term magnates. Okay, so it is not, there is no confirmation that is this the name of that place or the name of the shepherd that has been given. Okay, so this was all about the history or the discovery of magnets. So it can be true also, or it can be some fictional story also. Okay, so most probably people think that it is true, and this happens in a place called Greek. Place called Greek. So let's talk about magnet. So that was all about discoveries and the history of magnets. Okay, so first of all, as I told you that when the word magnet comes, we think that it is something by which we can play, okay, or it is attracted to some metals. Okay, so we see magnets in various things. As for example, we can see magnets in toys, in speakers, or we can say loudspeakers. Okay, then we can see it in what can be said, building materials. Building materials in the sense that we have a door, okay, some furnitures are made and it is made up of doors, okay, wooden doors, and magnet is attached at both end, and if you pull it, we can easily open the door, and when we leave, it will be opened. Others are, we can see it in toys, pens, okay, and in various other things. So it is most common. The small things. Okay, so we can say that a magnet is common nowadays. Okay, to what we can say, for our convenience, for our betterment. Okay, to make the product in an easier way. Okay, or to help us in various other things. So this was all about the term magnet. Means where we will find, or where actually we see. Now let's move towards different types of magnets. So we will talk about artificial magnets first of all. Artificial magnets. So what do you mean by artificial magnets? Artificial magnet means it's not natural. Actually, whatever the magnets that we get in the market, they all are artificial magnets. And what we discussed, according to the discovery of the magnets, that is natural. But natural magnets are very less, okay, and they have a very less strength also. So mostly artificial magnets are used. Okay, so magnets are the substance which have the property to attract iron. Substance which have the property to attract iron. Iron or iron objects, we can see. Okay, so in nature, certain rocks have the property of attracting iron. That means in nature, certain things, that means we can say that they're stone, okay, lodestone, okay, they have the properties to attract thing, but as I tell that it doesn't have the strength to attract a large amount of iron substance. Okay, so these are known as natural magnets. That means the magnets that we get in nature. Okay, so natural magnets. We can write substance found naturally and has property of and has property to attract iron. Okay, so substance that are found naturally in the earth, okay, are called natural magnets. Whereas magnets which are made in laboratories or factories, magnets made in laboratories or factories are called artificial magnets. Okay, that means the substance of the magnets that are found naturally are called natural magnets, and the substance which are made in laboratory, okay, or in lab, okay, or factories are called artificial magnets. So artificial magnets are of two types. Natural, as I told that we are not going to study about natural magnets because it is found naturally and it has very less use. Okay, mostly it is used in a magnetic field or to show the direction, or we can say a magnetic compass. Okay, it is used in as a magnetic compass, but mostly artificial magnets are used. And artificial magnets has been divided into two categories. Number one, permanent and electromagnet. Okay, so artificial magnets has been divided into two types, permanent magnets and electromagnets. Permanent magnets and electromagnets. So we will learn about permanent magnets. What do you mean by permanent magnets? So permanent magnets are usually made of alloys containing iron. That means it attracts iron, and it is made from the alloys of iron ores. Alloys mean its type. Okay, alloys mean its types of iron. So we have various types of irons called such as steel, iron, aluminium, cobalt, okay, nickel. So it is made from alloys of iron. Okay, it is made from alloys of iron, containing iron, such as steel, aluminium, nickel, cobalt, etc. Okay, so permanent magnets is made from the alloys of iron. So nowadays a special type of magnets called ceramic magnets are made from the oxides of iron, nickel and beryllium. So we have a new type of magnets that is called ceramic magnets, okay, that means it is a new type of magnets and more attractive. Okay, so that for doing work also it becomes easier to work with that magnet. So it is made from the oxides of iron, nickel. Beryllium, etc. Okay, so electromagnets are made up of winding a coil of insulated copper wire. Means it is a temporary magnet. It is a temporary magnet. Okay, electromagnets are mostly considered as temporary magnets because it is mostly magnetized by the electric current. That's why it is called electromagnet, by electric current. Okay, so for definition we can write that electromagnets are made by winding a coil of armature by winding a coil of coil of copper. That means what we can say, okay, if this is something, if this is metal, okay, and a copper coil is winded, and when electricity is passed in that copper wire, as you all know that copper is a good conductor of electricity and it will attract the things. Okay, so are made by winding a coil of insulated copper wire around a cylindrical piece of soft iron. That means in soft iron. Okay, and if electricity is passed, it acts as a magnet because it will be charged. But when electricity is not passed through it, then it will stop. And it is mostly used in what you can say, for lifting heavy objects, heavy metallic objects in the ports, mostly in sea ports. Bare bare trunk jo hote hai irons ke, okay, wo electromagnet, by the process of electromagnet only it is shifted from one place to another. Okay, so this was all about permanent magnets and electromagnets. So we can differentiate that permanent magnets are made from alloys of steel, iron and aluminium, whereas electromagnets are also termed as temporary magnets. Okay, they are also termed as temporary magnets, and it's made by winding a coil of copper in a soft iron, in soft iron. Okay, and when electricity is passed through it, it acts as a magnet, and when electricity is stopped, it loses its properties. That's why it is considered as temporary magnets. And I also explained about where it is mostly used. It is mostly used to lift heavy iron objects. Okay, so this was all about the definition of magnets. Now let's talk about shape of magnets. Okay, actually in terms of natural magnets, we don't have any shape. We don't have any shape in terms of natural magnets because it is naturally occurring in the rocks. Okay, but as I told that natural magnets are not much more used because it doesn't have it has less property of magnetism. So we have various types of magnets. Okay, that means we can say artificial magnets. So permanents are available in various shapes. Some common shapes of permanent magnets are shown below. Number one, bar magnets. Number two, we will talk about bar magnets and other magnets. Number two, U-shaped magnet or horseshoe magnet. Magnet or horseshoe magnet. Number three, we have needle shaped magnet or magnetic needle. Needle shaped magnets. So basically we have three types of magnets. Okay, bar magnets. Okay, bar magnets are simple. Okay, it is a rectangular in shape. That means it is shaped like this. Okay, and it has been colored. The colors can be given, and North Pole and South is written there. Okay, so this type of structure of a metal is there. It is termed as bar magnet. Similarly, U-shaped magnet. Is like this, north and south. This type of magnet can also be found, okay, and it is termed as U-shaped magnet or horseshoe magnet. It is same, जैसे घोड़ा का नाल जैसा होता है उसी के शेप में. Okay, then we have needle-shaped magnets, north and south. That means pointed at two ends. So basically we have three types of magnets. Bar magnets, which is mostly rectangular in shape, okay. U-shaped markets, mostly considered as horseshoe magnets. Then needle shaped magnets, okay, the shape of is like a shape of a needle. That means pointed at two ends. Okay, so this was all about types of magnets. So if the question can come that or define different types of magnets, so what you have to write? Bar magnets. And if you draw a diagram, then it will be very much better. Okay, because it will show you that you have understood about bar magnet, U-shaped magnet and needle shaped magnets. Now let's move towards another part, that is magnetic properties. Magnetic and non-magnetic properties. Or substance you can write, not properties, substance. So we have various types of substance near to us. That means you can say, just take an example of this only. Okay, that means this is a whiteboard marker. That means it's a pen. Okay, and it is a substance. So if I ask you that is it magnetic substance or not, then most probably your answer will be no, because when we put this pen made up of plastic close to a magnet, it will not get attracted. Okay, it will not attach to the magnets. Okay, similarly we have dust, it will also not attract. So in that case we can say that these two things are non-magnetic substances. But if you have a piece of iron, okay, or you can say metal, okay, or iron rail, then it can be said that it has a magnetic properties. So we will talk about magnetic and non-magnetic substances. Magnetic and non-magnetic substances. So to learn the difference between magnetic and non-magnetic substances, I have just explained you about these two things. That means a pen, okay, a whiteboard marker made up of plastic. Okay, so we have various types of substances. So for magnetic substances, we can say those substances which which are attracted to magnets are termed as magnetic substances. जैसे कि कोई भी सब्सटेंस जो मैग्नेट से अट्रैक्ट हो, मीन्स वो खींच ले अपनी तरफ, उसको हम लोग क्या कह सकते हैं, मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस. जैसे कि एग्जाम्पल वी हैव आयरन, कोबाल्ट, निकल, टिन, एटेक्स्ट, मोस्टली वी कैन से मेटल्स वी कैन कंसिडर एज मेटल्स. But those substances which do not get attached or attracted to magnet is called non-magnetic substances. Example, we have various example, as I told that plastics, then we can add wood also, attraction, there are various things, okay. So we have only mentioned plastic and woods. Wood also don't get attracted to magnets, and even plastics, they are not attracted to magnets, whereas iron, cobalt, nickel, tin or the alloys of these all things get attracted to magnets. An example, we have mostly metals. So this was all about magnetic